ميم. So the lam, six harakas. The meem, six harakas. And in between the two, ghunna of
two
harakas. Okay? Amr, can you recite for us? The alif, lam, meem.
Alif, lam, meem.
MashaAllah. Very good. What other surah has the beginning that is we should go to? Let's try. Al Imran is the same.
Surah
right.
Maryam.
So Surah Maryam, we'll get to there. Let's go in chronological order, excuse me. Let's try Surah Al-A'raf first. Surah Al-A'raf, and then move to okay, Surah Al-A'raf is the seventh surah in the Quran. Here in Surah Al-A'raf we have Alif, Lam, Mim, Sad. We have one more letter, Sad. Where does Sad come? Sad comes once again in the
six
harakas. Okay, so let us try Surah Al-A'raf. The beginning of Surah Al-A'raf would be like this. Alif Lam Mim Sad. Notice Lam, how long?
Six
harakas. Six harakas. Mim, how long?
Six
harakas. Six harakas. Sad, how long?
Six
harakas. Where was the ghunnah?
Between the
lam and the mim, and that is it. I didn't do a ghunna between the meem and the sad. Why? Because there is no ghunna between. Write out the meem, you will have a meem, ya meem. And then write out the sad, you begin with sad. This will be idhar shafawi. So there is no ghunna over here. Alif lam meem sad. So there's a ghunna between the lam and the meem, and there's no ghunna between the meem and the صاد. You also have a qalqala. Very good. Jazakallah khair. صاد. Okay? Because of the fact that we ended with a dal sound. Because we're pronouncing the letter. Okay? So we have one ghunna and one qalqala in the very muqatta'ah. So we're applying the previous rules. Nothing new. It's just that we're applying them in a different way. Let us move on to Surah Al-Ra'd now. Okay? Surah Al-Ra'd. Surah Al-Ra'd is what number in the Quran? 13. The 13th surah. Okay, here we have Alif, Lam, Mim, Ra. Here we have a Ra instead of the Sad. Now where does Ra come? Notice it is in this one. The second category. Okay, so we only elongated to two harakas. Alif, Lam, Mim, Ra. Ra. I didn't say Ra and move on. Because it is of the second category, where we only prolong it to
two
harakas. Let us move on to Surah Taha then, the next one. We're not going over all the surahs, just some of them that have these beginnings. What number is Surah Taha? Taha is 20. Okay. Taha, obviously both of them, right here, Ta and Ha. Okay, both of them are two harakas long. So we pronounce it Taha, Taha. If we were to make it longer, it's a mistake. Ta or Taha, mistake. Each one has to be two harakas. Taha. Okay, now let's move on to... Oh, we forgot Maryam actually, right?
Yes.
Maryam is a very interesting one because they have a lot of letters. Maryam is right before it, number 19. Okay, look at Maryam, surah number 19. We have the kaf. Firstly, the kaf. Where's the kaf?
Six
over here.
Harakas.
Six harakas. Then we have the ha.
Two harakas.
Then we have the ya. Where is the ya? Also two harakas. Then we have the ayn.
Six harakas.
Six harakas. Then we have the
sad.
Six harakas. So we have six, two, two, six, six. Now we also have to look at the rules of ghunna.
Yes.
Kaf ha obviously will not have any ghunna between it. Ha ya ayn sad.
That's it.
So there will have a ghunna here because ayn you write it ayn ya noon. And then you begin with the sad. This will be what type of ghunna?
Ikhfa.
And then there will be a qalqala where? At the end of sad, because there's a silent dal. So we'll recite this one. Kaf ha ya ayn sad. Okay, so we notice we have the kaf, six harakas, the ha, two, ya, two, ayn, six, ayn is six.
Ayn
is six, with the ikhfa, with the ghunna, and then the sad has the qalqala. Okay? The ayn is considered a madlin, but we'll do it six, it is considered to be six over here as well. So why don't we all both do kaf, ayn, sad, repeat after me. كافها يا عين صاد
كافها يا عين صاد.
Okay, so once again, it's very easy. You just remember the letters that are there and you see which ones apply to where. Let us go to another surah. Let us try Surah Ash-Shura, which is Surah number 43 in the Quran. Surah Ash-Shura.
42,
you're right, 42 of the Quran. Here we have a ha and a meem, and then ayn, seen, qaf. Okay, so we have once again five letters here. So yes. Once again, we notice that only the ha is of the two harakas, and then the meem is down here.
Six.
Also the ayn. Also the seen, also the qaf, okay? Hamim Ain Sin Qaf. Here we have the ha, two harakas.
Yes.
Seen, meem was?
Six
harakas. Obviously, there's no qalqa, no ghunna, because nothing comes after it. Meem. Ain, what happened here? We have the six, and then we have a ghunna
yes.
after it. Ikhfa. Ayn, the ghunna there. Then we have the seen, six harakas, another ikhfa. Seen, qaf. But there's no qalqala because we end on a fa, qaf. So there's no qalqala. Hamim, ayn, seen, qaf. So we have ha, two, mim, ayn, sin, qaf was six each, and we did the particular ghunnas and the qalqalas that were done before. So this is a pretty easy topic, alhamdulillah. We're talking about the muqatta'at, the beginning of the surahs, and we merely divide them into three categories. The first category is the letter which is pronounced without any mad, and that is the alif. The second are those five letters which are pronounced with a mad of two harakas, and that is
Hayyun
Tahura, the five letters of Hayyun Tahura. And the final category are the letters that are pronounced with a mud of six harakas, and these are Naqasa Aslakum. And make sure that when you pronounce them, you do the proper ghunnas and the proper qalqalas where applicable. This brings us to the conclusion of today's episode. I hope to see you in our next episode. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.